Hi, good morning everybody. Today in this video we shall be discussing about a new chapter from civics, chapter number 2, understanding secularism. Okay, now in this chapter we will read about secularism. Okay, can anyone think of what is secular? Or I hope you all have read this line many a times: India is a secular state. Okay, so can you frame the definition of secularism? Okay, yes, good. Okay, so now I am telling you the definition of secularism. The definition of secularism means that in a country, in a society, in a community, all the religions are equal. Okay, every religion has equal status, equal class, and equal freedom to freedom, right to express, all the fundamental rights, all the fundamental duties are available in the country, in the society, to every religion. Okay, now, and if in Hindi I say being secularism in is dharm nirpekshta. Okay, secularism ko Hindi mein kya kaha jata hai? Dharm nirpekshta. Okay, now after that we will move further in this chapter and I shall be telling you why the need of secularism occur in India, what's the important factor of secularism, how secularism is playing its important role. Or okay, now before starting the chapter, let's take a recap about the factor religion discrimination or discrimination on the basis of religion. Okay, this is highly discriminated everywhere. If we go in any other part of the country, like every country has their own religion. If you go to Pakistan, to Saudi Arabia, okay, so these countries have Muslim religion. Okay, now if you go to England, USA, the people there have what? Christian religion. Okay, and if you go to the China, if you go to Nepal, if you go to other part of just like the people there, they follow Buddhism. Okay, now they have their religion of Gautam Buddha. Okay, now and in India there are main four religions: Hinduism, Sikhism, Muslim, Christianity. And as you all know, my dear students, all the people of every religion, every caste that lives in a society, they are secular in reason. They have secularity in with them. They have all kind of freedoms with them. Okay, so we can say India is a secular state ki jahan pe Bharat mein kisi bhi dharm ke saath koi bhedbhav nahi kiya jata, kisi bhi dharm ke logo ke saath koi pakshpat nahi kiya jata. All peoples are equal and they have equal rights for their freedoms. Okay, now let's start the chapter. Okay, suppose imagine yourself as a Hindu Muslim living in a part of United States of America where Christian fundamentalism is very powerful. Suppose that despite being a US citizen, no one is willing to rent their house to you. How would you this make you feel? Would it not make you feel resentful? What if you decide to complain against this discrimination and where told to go back to India? Would this not make feel angry? Your anger could take two forms. First, you might react by saying that Christians should get the same treatment in the places where Hindus and Muslims are in a majority. This is a form of retaliation. Okay, or you might take the view that there should be justice for all. You may fight stating that no one should be discriminated against on grounds of their religious practices and beliefs. This statement rests on the assumption that all forms of domination related to religion should end. This is a sensation of secularism. In this chapter you will read more about what this means in the Indian context. Okay, I hope you have understood the paragraph. Suppose you are a Hindu or a Muslim or and आपको USA के किसी शहर में जाना है किसी काम से और वहाँ के नेटिव पीपल का कौन सा धर्म होता है क्रिश्चियनिटी आई टोल्ड यू एंड दे आर नॉट विलिंग टू रेंट टू पे योर होम ऑन रेंट बिकॉज यू आर अ हिंदू और अ मुस्लिम फ्रॉम डिफरेंट पार्ट ऑफ अ कंट्री एंड यू डोंट बिलोंग टू USA सो दे आर अफ्रेड ऑफ यू they are not willing to give you their home on rent so how would you feel aapko acha to nahi lagega na obviously you will feel insecure aapke andar jealousy ki feeling aa jayegi aapke andar prejudice aa jayega ki that mere sath yahan pe galat hua to fir aap kya karoge ya to aap jis bande ne aapko matlab aapke sath ye discrimination kiya hai uske khilaf usi ki country mein report karoge okay uske khilaf koi aap एक्शन लोगे अदरवाइज वट यू विल डू यू विल कम बैक टू यूर कंट्री एंड एट दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑफ टाइम यू विल थिंक दैट जैसा इसने मेरे साथ किया है ना वैसा ही अगर ये मेरे देश में आएगा तब मैं भी इसके साथ करूँगा ओके दिस फीलिंग ऑफ जेलेसी दिस फीलिंग ऑफ प्रिजुडिस इज कॉल्ड रिटेलिएशन ओके दिस फीलिंग इज कॉल्ड रिटेलिएशन ओके नाउ Now let's start the chapter. History provides us with many examples of discrimination, exclusion and persecution on the ground of religion. You may have read about how Jews were persecuted in Hitler's Germany and how several millions were killed. Now, however, the Jewish state of Israel treats its own Muslim and Christian minorities quite badly. In Saudi Arabia, non-Muslims are not allowed to build a temple, church, etc. and nor can they gather in a public place for prayers okay as I told you in many of the countries they follow their own main religion and a example is given here like in the countries of Saudi Arabia Israel the Christians people are treated very badly they are not allowed to gather in their church they are not allowed to recite the prayer for their own people okay so now this is a discrimination on the basis of religion like people in Saudi Arabia Israel they are treating their religion above all the other okay now in all of the above examples member of one religious community either persecute or discriminate against members of other religious communities these acts of discrimination take place more easily when one religion is given official recognition by the state at the expense of other religions clearly no one would wish to be discriminated against because of their religion nor dominated by another religion in India can the state discriminate against a citizen on the grounds of their religion now I ask you this question and you answer yourself क्या आपको लगता है कि भारत में किसी भी धर्म के लोगों के साथ किसी भी धर्म की औरतों के साथ किसी भी धर्म के बच्चों के साथ या बड़े बुजुर्गों के साथ कभी भी कोई डिस्क्रिमिनेशन होता है नहीं होता ना हाँ सो इस बेस पे हम कह सकते हैं कि इंडिया इज ए सेक्युलर स्टेट नाउ दिस इज द पैराग्राफ दैट विल टेल यू अबाउट व्हाट इज बीइंग सेक्युलरिज्म ओके In the previous chapter, you read about how the Indian Constitution contains fundamental rights that protect us against state power as well as against the tyranny of the majority. Okay, the Indian Constitution allows individuals the freedom to live by their religious belief and practices as they interpret this. In keeping with this idea of religious freedom for all, India also adopted a strategy of separating the power of religion and the power of the state. Secularism refers to this separation of religion from the state. Okay, now as I told you, in the Indian Constitution, there are fundamental rights and fundamental duties are also there. So, in India, as a secular state, all the fundamental duties and fundamental rights are available for every citizen of our country, no matter whether he or she is a Muslim, a Christian, a Hindu, or a Sikh. So, all these things are equally provided to the every citizen of India and yes it is saying that whether state or a center cannot interfere in the fundamental rights of a native people ठीक है कि भाई अगर कोई भी मेजोरिटी ऑफ ग्रुप या मेजोरिटी ऑफ पीपल किसी एक माइनॉरिटी क्लास को दबा रहा है, सुपरवाइज कर रहा है, उसको सुप्रेस कर रहा है, तो फिर ये गलत है एंड वो स्टेट का या फिर सेंटर का नैतिक दायित्व बन जाता है उनके फंडामेंटल राइट्स की रक्षा करना, बिकॉज व्हाई इंडिया इज ए सेकुलर स्टेट. ओके, नाउ लुक एट दिस. ओके, आवर Unity lies in our diversity. Okay, हमारी एकता lies in our diversity. Okay, see, this is a temple, this is a church, this is a gurudwara, and this is a mosque or masjid. Okay, so all the four main religions of India are shown in this. And see, Sikh, Hindu, and Muslim childrens are playing together. So India is dharm nirpeksh country, or I can say sabhi dharm sambhav. Okay, so India is a secular state. Now let's start a new concept of this chapter. Why is it important to separate religion from state? Matlab ye jaruri kyon hai dharm ko एक डिस्ट्रिक्ट, एक राज्य, एक जिले से अलग रखना, और ये बहुत ज़्यादा जरूरी है. एंड आई शैल टेल यू विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस पैराग्राफ. ओके, एज डिस्कस्ड अबाउट, द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट ऑफ सेकुलरिज्म इज इट्स सेपरेशन ऑफ रिलीजन फ्रॉम स्टेट पावर. दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ए कंट्री टू फंक्शन डेमोक्रेटिकली. ऑलमोस्ट ऑल कंट्रीज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड विल हैव मोर देन वन रिलीजन ग्रुप लिविंग इन दैम. विद दीज रिलीजियस ग्रुप्स देयर विल मोस्ट लाइकली बी वन ग्रुप दैट इज इन ए मेजोरिटी. इफ दिस majority religious groups has access to state power, then it could quite easily use this power and financially resources to discriminate against and persecute person of the other religion. This tyranny of the majority could result in the discrimination culture, at times even the killings of religious minorities. The majority could quite easily prevent minorities from practicing their religions. Any form of dominated based on the religion is in violation of the rights that a democratic society guarantees to each other and every citizen irrespective of their religion. Therefore, the tyranny of the majority and the violation of fundamental rights can result is one reasons why is it important to separate the state and the religions in a democratic societies. So with the help of this paragraph, we can say that suppose you are living in a society and where all the people of different religions, different culture and caste lives together. Okay, now there is one religion that is in majority over there and all the other religions are minority in number. Okay, so like there is a proper water supply and the water came in the morning and the shortage of electricity is there and all other essential tools are also came on a particular period of time. So the majority class took the feeling of being superior among all of them and what they do, they ki bhai hum pehle pani bharenge, hum pehle electricity lenge, hum pehle khana lenge, hum pehle ye lenge. So wo baki jo wahan pe log reh rahe hain unko kya kar rahe hain, wo daba rahe hain. Aur ye kya hai, ye galat hai, ये उनके फंडामेंटल राइट्स की भी वायलेशन है, ये उनकी फ्रीडम ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन की भी वायलेशन है एंड उनके राइट टू लाइफ एक्ट की भी वायलेशन है. ओके, सो इन सब चीज़ों की वजह से कभी कभी हमारे देश में वायलेशन भी हो जाती है बिटवीन, आपको पता होगा कि हमारे देश में दंगे भी बहुत ज़्यादा हो जाते हैं बिटवीन हिंदूज एंड मुस्लिम्स एंड ऑल अदर रिलीजियंस लाइक यादव एंड गुज्जर्स. सो जस्ट टू शो दी सुपीरियरिटी, ये सब इसलिए दिखाते हैं कि भाई हम सुपीरियर हैं, बट नो वन इज सुपीरियर. ऑल दी रिलीजन्स आर इक्वल, ऑल दी कॉस्ट आर इक्वल एंड ऑल दी पीपल ऑफ इंडिया आर इक्वल. सो एक स्टेट में वायलेशन ना हो, एक स्टेट में आपस में लड़ाई झगड़ाई ना हो, फाइटिंग्स नहीं हो, आर्ग्यूमेंट्स नहीं हो, एंड सो देस टू मेंटेन अ बैलेंस अमंग ऑल दी रिलीजन्स. It is very important टू सेपरेट रिलीजन फ्रॉम द स्टेट. ओके, सो इसलिए हम कहते हैं कि जो स्टेट है वो राज्य से या जिले से अलग है. ठीक है, बिकॉज धर्म सबसे पहले है. ओके, सो भाई किसी के फंडामेंटल राइट्स, फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज का ना आदर ना हो, सबको अच्छे से रहने का मौका मिले, ऑल द पीपल्स हैव एक्सेस टू ऑल द एसेंशियल टूल्स ऑफ लाइफ इन एन इक्वल मैनर. ओके, सो जस्ट टू प्रिवेंट दीज फीलिंग्स ऑफ सेटिस्फेक्शन एंड टू प्रोवाइड अ कंफर्ट जोन टू ऑल द नेटिव पीपल, इट इज इम्पोर्टेंट टू सेपरेट रिलीजन फ्रॉम द स्टेट. नाउ सी दिस पिक्चर. ओके, नाउ दिस इज ए मस्जिद, दिस इज ए मंदिर टेम्पल, एंड दिस इज ए गुरुद्वारा, एंड दिस इज ए चर्च, और वी कैन से मुस्लिम, हिंदू, सिखिज्म एंड चर्च. ओके, सो एंड जस्ट सी हम साथ साथ हैं. ओके, नाउ सिख, मुस्लिम, हिंदू एंड क्रिश्चियंस चिल्ड्रंस showing their love, showing their care, showing their affection to each other and respecting the feeling of their culture, tradition and the happiness of all the festival of all the different religions. Like in a community where Hindu are there, where Muslims are there, Christians are there, Sikhism are there, together we all celebrate the festival of Eid, together we celebrate Ramzan, together we celebrate Holi, Diwali, Raksha Bandhan, Dashera, and together we celebrate Lohri, Baisakhi, Guru Nanak Jayanti and all other religious festival of Christianity also, like Christmas, okay, Good Friday. Okay, so now our unity lies in the diversity. Okay, now what is Indian secularism? Okay, pay attention, this is an important topic. Okay, the Indian constitution mandates that the Indian state be secular. According to the constitution, only a secular state can realize its objective to ensure the following: that one religious community does not dominate another. First point, that one religious community does not dominate another. मतलब कि जो एक religion class एक society पे, एक community में, majority में है, वो बाकी दूसरे religions के ऊपर अपनी अपनी power या अपनी superiority वाली feeling बिल्कुल भी नहीं दिखाएगी, दूसरों को another बिल्कुल भी नहीं करेगी. ये सरासर गलत है according to our Indian constitution, because all the religions are equal, all the castes are equal, all the languages are equal, and all the citizens of our India are equal. Okay, now second, that some member do not dominate other members of the same religious community. I told you this also, that the state does not enforce any particular religion nor take away the religious freedoms of the individuals. Ki bhai aap dusro ke धर्म में ना तो कभी हस्तक्षेप करेंगे, ना ही उनको कभी गलत बताएंगे, और ना ही उनको धर्म बदलने के लिए कहेंगे. सो दिस इज आल्सो एन इलीगल. सो दिस थ्री एस्पेक्ट्स और थ्री पॉइंट्स लेड बाय द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया आर रियली बेनिफिशियल फॉर सेइंग दैट इंडिया इज ए सेकुलर स्टेट. ओके, the Indian state works in various ways to prevent the above domination. First, it uses a strategy of distancing itself from religions. Ki bhai hum aajkal kya hai ki today's generations is keeping themselves away from these kinds of feeling of discrimination among इंडिविजुअल्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रिलीजन्स, कि हम इन सब बातों में विश्वास नहीं रखते हैं. ठीक है, द इंडियन स्टेट इज़ नॉट रूल्ड बाई अ रिलीजियस ग्रुप एंड नॉर डज इट सपोर्ट एनी वन रिलीजन्स. और सेकेंड, कि भाई जो भारत सरकार है या भारत की जनता है, जो भारत के मिनिस्टर्स होते हैं, ये तो नहीं है कि भाई भारत एक हिंदू के द्वारा चलाया जाता है. यहाँ पे मतलब हिंदूज भी चलाते हैं, यहाँ पे सिखिज्म भी चलाते हैं, और यहाँ पे मुस्लिम्स भी चलाते हैं, और क्रिश्चियंस भी चलाते हैं. आपको पता होगा कि डॉक्टर भारत के राष्ट्रपिता, द ग्रेट साइंटिस्ट ऑफ इंडिया अब्दुल कलाम साहब, वह मुस्लिम थे. ओके, नाउ नरेंद्र मोदी इज़ अ हिंदू, एंड that in Punjab, Captain Amrinder Singh, the CM of Punjab, he is a Sikh people. Navjot Singh Sidhu, the minister in the Punjab government, he is a Hindu. He is a Sikh. So all the community in the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha have equal status for their equal number of rights. Okay, now in the Lok Sabha there are many Muslims, great leaders also. Okay, so and the Indian state is not ruled by a religious group, and nor does it support any one religion. In India, government space like law, courts, police stations, government schools and offices are not supposed to display or promote any one religions. यहाँ तक कि हमारे देश में, हमारे देश की न्यायपालिका, police stations, schools, colleges, government officials, private institutions, जितनी भी संस्थाएं हैं हमारे देश में, वो कभी भी एक एक देश के उसको फॉलो नहीं करती हैं, ठीक है, कभी भी एक धर्म को